The Whirlwind computer came online at MIT in 1949. It occupied 3,300 square feet within a two-story building, contained 12,500 tubes, 23,803 crystal rectifiers, and 1,800 relays, and consumed 150 kilowatts of power. It was also one of only a handful of computers on the planet. It would have been impossible to imagine what the next decades would bring. Today, more computational capacity is manufactured every few milliseconds than existed in 1949. Computational devices have become so pervasive that most of the time we don't even realize that we are using them. Computation keeps our planes in the air and our cars on the road. It manages our electrical, communication, and financial systems, controls homes and pacemakers, and, perhaps most importantly, computation has changed the way we think about the world. Computational thinking has become an essential tool in engineering, science, the social sciences, and even some branches of humanities. In the coming decades, neuroscientists will use computational thinking to probe the mystery of intelligence. Biologists will use computational techniques to understand genes and proteins. Climatologists will build computational models that will help man predict the consequences of societal behaviors. Artists will find new ways of using computation to express their creativity. For 7 years, MIT's EECS department has taught a course, 600, that helped people who have never programmed learn to use the computer to help them become more productive at whatever it is they want to do. That course, N600X, braid together four strands of material: the basics of programming, the Python programming language, computational thinking and modeling, and analysis of data. If you successfully complete 600X, you will have learned a language, Python, for expressing computations, learned a systematic approach to writing and debugging medium-sized programs, developed an informal understanding of computational complexity, learned a useful set of algorithmic and problem reduction techniques, developed some insight into the process of moving from an ambiguous problem statement to a computational formulation of a method for solving the problem, learned how to use simulations to shed light on problems that don't easily succumb to closed-form solutions, and learned how to use computational tools, including simple statistical and plotting tools, to model and understand data.